My name is Heïdi Sevestre. I'm a French glaciologist and international fellow of the Explorers Club. And I'd like to take you with me on my expeditions in high latitude or high altitude environments. I can't wait to share it all with you, and I certainly hope that you're ready to embark on some amazing adventures. All right, let's go!
Making some progress. What is the altitude here? Almost 4,700 meters. And there's a very interesting sign here that says that the glacier was here only 16 years ago, believe it or not. Now it's so far away, right? We can see it very clearly. We probably have 200-300 meters to cover. It's impressive the chaos that the glacier has left behind. We know very little about what's happening underneath glaciers, and sometimes we think it's all smooth and nice, eroded by the ice, but actually it's a chaos of rocks. And terrains like these are fantastic actually to study the pioneer vegetation that is the first one to come and colonize these environments. So it's absolutely beautiful. But now we're going to go and meet the team. They are drilling some stakes on the glacier, some ablation stakes, and it should be very, very useful to measure actually the melting and the thinning of the glacier. So here we are finally arriving at the ice. Oof, it's very debris covered. It's full of gravels. Very dirty ice. Very, very dirty. So it has snowed recently, so you cannot see, but yeah, this is ice that's completely debris covered. So here we are today overlooking the Conajeras Glacier. So this glacier is one of the many tropical glaciers of Colombia. And here we are on the Santa Isabel Mountain. What we're doing is we're installing a time-lapse camera just here with the team from IDEAM. So they've been very, very helpful. And we're installing a time-lapse camera that is built by a French team called ENLAPS. What we're doing is actually monitoring the retreat of the glacier. As you can see, the glacier is quite a small one. It's actually smaller than 0.1 square kilometers.
And the glacier is probably going to be one of the first ones disappearing here on the Santa Isabel Mountain. So the group of glaciologists are monitoring this glacier very closely. First of all, they do mass balance measurements. What they do is measuring whether the glacier is thinning or thickening. And here in the tropics, it's not like anywhere else in the world where you have a season when the glacier accumulates mass and a season when the glacier loses mass. Here it can change from one day to another. But this glacier, more or less on average, is losing about 2.5 meters of water equivalent every year, which is a lot. But also, the glacier is retreating a lot. It's losing about 20 to 25 meters in length in area every year. So this is why we installed a camera here. This camera will be in place for 2 years, which is incredible. And it's going to be taking pictures every 2 hours from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening. So I really can't wait to see what the camera is taking. I hope it will stay in place, that this mountain is not going to crumble down. But this is very precious information for us, and it will really help us to monitor the retreat of the glacier and probably its disappearance.